Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. In the previous video, we used the 4-point tracking data from Mocha Pro to composite the logo onto the moving truck with Autodesk Smoke. Now we have created a new issue where the new element is naturally in front of everything else. So we need to mask the foreground elements and recompose them on top of the original footage. In this case, the van needs to be in the foreground. Now, Smoke does have masking tools to do this efficiently, but since this series is about the interoperability between Mocha Pro and Autodesk Smoke, we'll go back to Mocha Pro and do the masking there. So here we have the Mocha Pro setup where the van has been masked and tracked in the shot. You'll notice that the van's side mirror has also been rotoscoped separately because it only appears in the middle of the shot. For more information on Mocha Pro and tutorials on how to use Mocha Pro, please visit Imagineer Systems' website. To export these masks into Smoke, you need to export each layer separately. Select the van layer in the list. Now in the Track tab, click Export Shape Data. Choose the Flame Gmask script choice from the pop-up menu. Navigate to a location in the file browser and give the mask an appropriate name. Now save it. Select the van mirror layer and repeat the same steps. Click Export Shape Data, check the format and click Save. Give the mask a name and save it. Going back into Smoke, we will use the exported masks to bring the van back into the foreground so that the logo on the truck is correctly behind the van. So we need to create a new alpha channel or mat for the van. To make this alpha channel, we are going to use a Gmask node. Press the home icon to return to the ConnectFX default view. In the ConnectFX node bin, press G to bring up the Gmask node. Drag it into the schematic and connect the background image into the Gmask input. Double-click the Gmask node to bring up its menus and the Gmask result view. In the middle of the interface, click the Load button to go to the browser. Now navigate to the location of the exported van mask. Select and load the mask. Now we have the mask that was produced in Mocha Pro, and as I scrub the time bar, it is tracking the van. You have various settings in Smoke to adjust the mask. Please note that the mask is keyframed, so you need to ensure auto key is on for any adjustments you make. For example, you can switch to the softness of the mask and adjust the offset. This is useful for masking objects as blurring occurs on their edges when in a state of motion. Let's complete the mask by clicking Load and loading the mirror of the van as well. Smoke combines both masks together in the shot, and I'll quickly soften this mask. So we're happy with the new alpha from the mask, and now let's recombine it on top of our image. Press the home icon to return to the ConnectFX default view. Select the action node and press Ctrl N to add a new media input for action. Since the background image has the van in it, we will simply connect this image as the new input for this media input node. The Gmask node contains the new alpha channel, so we'll connect that as the mat input. So action will combine all the layers together, and as we scrub through the time bar, you can see how these are effectively composited together. In the next video, we will add 3D camera tracking data into the composition to composite a 3D model into the shot. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning Channel for future videos.